It's not just about buses. This is about adding to the economic value of Hampton Roads. And even though you and I may choose not to use public transit, we benefit from it. Cars are taken off the road, and the fact people that we rely on use public transportation. So whether you use it or not, you benefit from it.
I want you to repeat that line, because that's the one that really hit home with me.
Yes.
I ride the Tide all the time, but I haven't been on a bus in years. But I rely on
those people that use public transportation. And that's really important for us all to understand. And as congestion continues to grow in Hampton Roads, and clearly studies show and surveys prove that that is the number one concern that residents, business people, visitors have about this area, there are going to be more individuals that consider public transportation. So what we're saying is, let's plan for it. Let's put together a plan. Let's find resources to put together a multimodal community so that we can all have access to public transportation.
Long before you were president, there was a multitude of product that Hampton Road or Tidewater Transit did.
Yes.
But they really never were connected as a corporate entity, were they?
Well, that's a good point. The bottom line is, you had TRT on the south side, but you had Penn-Tran on the north side.
Yeah.
And the bottom line is, currently, the way we contract for public transportation is each city buys as much or as little as they can afford based on other general fund needs. And when you look at other viable areas, other regions, what you find is that there is a regional funding source which contributes to the multimodal situation. So that's what we're missing in Hampton Roads.
So your host here just remembered when, but we're still funding it and supporting it in a remember when world rather than the futuristic world you're building.
Absolutely.
And did I hit on the head?
You really did. And I think what's going to be important is that we have to understand public transportation and what it means to Hampton Roads, our future economy, how we attract millennials, how aging baby boomers get around, and how we rethink navigating the region. And I think, you know, connecting downtown Norfolk with the town center in Virginia Beach, it would be a major plus for the Tide, where you're actually connecting economic centers versus the Norfolk Center down to a Newtown Road park and ride station. So we need people to see that we're talking about a larger regional vision of how to enhance public transportation as we improve roads, bridges, and tunnels. We are not in conflict with those facilities. In fact, mm-hmm. we help you bring out better capacity in those systems.
I still go back to the, and it's a reality. There was a news anchor on one of the other stations that made a point about walking from her home to the nearest bus stop, which is like 2.5 miles down the southern part of Virginia Beach. But that really kind of, not necessarily that you have to walk to a stop, but the park and rides, again, if you look at your own personal use of mass transit, it is a system. Supported that,
right? It truly is a system, and we have a lot of work to do. It's no question. You know, that first mile, last mile, we're talking to Uber. We're trying to figure out how. Yeah, we're trying to figure out how we can help connect people to get to public transportation, because that is a barrier for so many. It's about better technology, on-time performance. It's about bus rapid transit, it's about light rail, it's about a stronger bus system that has better frequencies, that you don't have to wait an hour for a bus. That really breeds transit-dependent riders.
Mm-hmm.
Choice riders aren't going to wait an hour if they miss a bus. So we have to be able to create a system where it's attractive to use the bus and other forms of public transportation. It's also about the bike and pedestrian connections mm-hmm. that you referred to.
Because she could ride her bike that 2.5.
Absolutely.
Not that I'm challenging
right.
her to.
And we have bus racks that on our bus, and you can bring your bike on light rail. So the bottom line is, we're trying to put together the elements of a system that's effective for moving around Hampton Roads.
Okay, so how do you go, and I'm gonna be real candid here then.
Yes.
How do you go from being, well, we are what we are because we are, how we're funded, to we're in the driver's seat and we're gonna change how we do connectivity in Hampton Roads, which is what you're doing?
Yeah, it's a super question. I mean, HRT has been a bus company, but we're trying to be so much more than that. I think it's a number of things that have to happen. Quite frankly, you know, we have to do a better job selling a regional vision of what Hampton Roads mm-hmm. can be.
Own it, in other words.
Yes, we got to own it. The other thing is we have to work very carefully with the transportation planning organization. Bob Crum is the new executive mm-hmm. director there. He has a really broad vision of what Hampton Roads can become. I think they play a major role in terms of helping to build regional support for a multimodal system. I think what we've also seen working and looking at other communities is the business community has to play a major role in terms of educating and getting behind the benefits of what a regional multimodal system brings to the community. I'm pleased to say both the Southside and Peninsula Chambers have been very supportive of the Connect Hampton Roads campaign, mm-hmm. which is kind of the beginnings of what we hope will become a regional initiative to improve public transportation.
How can the public, pardon the pun, get on board?
ConnectHamptonRoads.com. That's a great place to begin to read up in terms of what's happening with that particular plan. Also, we intend to have a forum in June. I think it's the 27th. I'll get back to you on that date, where we are going to bring in leaders from around the country to talk about transformational transit, how the extension of light rail and other public transportation helped spur job creation, diversification of the economy, mm-hmm. you name it, in other communities around the United States. So we want to learn from others and find out what we in Hampton Roads can do to get become a part and get on board with Connect Hampton Roads.
So what you're telling me, it's not about light rail from Newtown Road out to the beach?
No, that is one of the early incremental steps of growing a regional system, which not only is going to have high capacity transit, but also is going to have improved bus service, which is going to have shelters and amenities, like the DNTC, our new transit center mm-hmm. that Norfolk funded, $4 million of, the state came for it with $2 million. I mean, that is a beautiful facility with restrooms and amenities to get out of the elements. That's something that most people would say should be part of a system, but historically that's not really been how we're funded. So I think it's important that we grow the system, create something that's unique, something we haven't seen, and I think what we'll see are results that are going to help change the trajectory of our region.
Okay, we're going to bring it home to Norfolk now, because
yes.
a couple of years ago we were involved in a community outreach to talk yes. about the extension of light rail, forget Newtown East, within Norfolk, and we had, gosh, 300, 400 residents saying, we got shovels, we'll start building.
Well,
what's the timeline look like?
Well,
we'll start building.
Well, we're ready to go. You know, I think we've got to go through a process because we know federal dollars will be important mm-hmm. as we advance this particular process. And we're going to have two processes. And we're going to be coming to the Norfolk City Council with an overview. So I'm not going to unveil not too much. But
folks,
you heard it first right here on Bob Batcher's show. But there are going to be two elements of that study, an eastern alignment mm-hmm. that would address the airport and getting people to Naval Station Norfolk quickly, because there's a great need. The majority of people that work at Naval Station Norfolk come from Virginia Beach, right. Chesapeake, and then Norfolk being the third most significant generator of employees to Naval Station Norfolk. But also there's a need to really connect with the existing alignment at EVMC and then work your way through Old Dominion University, weave through Ghent, you name it. So there are going to be two separate studies, if you will, to look at what is the best way to get those connections. And I think it's going to be really exciting. One of the things we love about working in Norfolk is there's so much interest in high capacity transit. Mm-hmm. People care about it, people understand it. And clearly Norfolk is the leader in terms of providing a multimodal options for its citizens.
Well, and you can't really talk about military highway corridor without talking about transportation corridor.
Exactly.
And one thing we're engaged in now with the Vision 2100 and the whole planning about what's the city of Norfolk going to be like in the 22nd century, in 2100, yes. That what's come out of those community meetings, and it might be because of the early work we did, was knowing that the leading edge, the spear, the tip of the spear, is going to be light rail or some form of mass transit.
Yeah, I think you're making that connection, which has to be made. And when you look at that old military circle, Janeth area, you know, you guys are doing all sorts of plans there. So I think it's a very smart move to look at how high capacity transit can help with the reinvestment mm-hmm. in that particular corridor, while at the same time addressing the airport and getting people to Naval Station Norfolk very quickly. At the same time, you have Old Dominion University mm-hmm. that anchors that western.
We love line. ODU, by the way.
We absolutely love ODU. They are very interested in more public transportation. Yeah. They have a better use of their properties other than parking garages, and we think that's good for the region, and it's certainly good for all of us.
One of our long-range transportation planners that's with the city has made the observation that our bus routes were laid down, the footprint of them, in post-World War II.
Yes.
This conversation is saying, okay, that might be true, but how do we lay down our transportation system for the next 85 years? Is really the conversation we're having now. Rather than just reinforcing what we used to do.
Absolutely, and we're flying the plane at the same time we're trying to repair
it. Painful though, isn't it?
It is absolutely painful, but we have to do it. We have to look at a vision for where those new development centers are. There's been all sorts of residential development throughout Norfolk. We need to make sure that we provide adequate service to those areas. The new jobs that are coming to the city of Norfolk is so exciting. There's an opportunity there to provide go passes to those new employees coming in. The bottom line is the region has changed greatly, mm-hmm. and we need to have the ability to rethink how we provide public transportation. But we need your help to get the information out, Bob.
Well, I was going to ask you, and we got 1 minute left, so I'm going to throw you the hot potato. You've taken HRT that used to be controlled by the political arena region-wide. And now you're starting to set that vision for the politicians to react to, right?
Yes.
How'd you do it? You got 30 seconds.
Well, I've got a great team. And one of the things I recognize is you're only good as the people around you. So I have a wonderful team that is not only dealing with the day-to-day mechanics of improving public transportation, but we're looking strategically how we can really blend into what is needed to advance this region. And this is my home, so this is more than an advocation for me. This is what I believe in.
And then you hit it on the head earlier before I asked the question. How do you get involved? Hampton Roads Connect?
ConnectHamptonRoads.com.
Got it. Sir, thank you.
Absolutely. It's always a pleasure.
You wore me out. I'll do anything you want me to do.
I'm fired up.
Here we go. Thanks for joining us.